She gave me The Moonstone to read. That was the first I read of Wilkie Collins. East Lynne I read, and The Shadow of Ashley that Mrs. Henry Wood. Henry Dunbar, by that other woman I lent him afterwards, with Mulvey's photo in it. So is he. See, I wasn't without. And Lord Lytton. Eugene, Aram Molly Bond, she gave me by Mrs. Hungerford on account of the name. I don't like books with Molly in them. Like that one he brought me about the one in Flanders, a whore out with shoplifting anything she could, cloth and stuff and yards of it. Oh, this blanket is too heavy for me. That's better. I haven't one decent nightdress. This thing gets all rolled up under me besides him and his fooling. That's better. I used to be weltering then in the heat. My shift, drenched with the sweat, stuck in the cheeks of my bottom on the chair. When I stood up, they were so fattish and firm. I got on the sofa cushions to see my clothes up, and the bugs, tons of them at night, and the mosquito nets. I couldn't read a line. Lord, how long ago it seems. Centuries, of course, they never come back. And she didn't put her address right on it, either. She may have noticed her wagger. People were always going away, and we never... I remember that day with the waves and the boats, with the high heads rocking, and the smell of ship. Those officers' uniforms on shore leave made me sick. He didn't say anything. He was very serious. I had the high-buttoned boots on, and my skirt was blowing. She kissed me 6 or 7 times. Didn't I cry? Yes, I believe I did, or near it. My lips were tatering when I said goodbye. She had a gorgeous wrap of some special kind of blue colour on her for the voyage, made very peculiarly to one side, like. And it was extremely pretty. It got as dull as the devil after they went. I was almost planning to run away, mad, out of it somewhere. We're never easy where we are. Father sent our marriage. Waiting, always waiting to guide him to me. Waiting, or speed his flying feet.